Let's shit talk our own country again for a little while. For the first time ever, U.S. billionaires...
I mean, we kind of just were.
Yeah. Yeah. For the first time ever, U.S. billionaires pay lower tax rate than workers.
Oh.
A new book-length study on the tax burden of the ultra-rich begins with a startling finding. In 2018, for the first time in history, America's richest billionaires paid a lower effective tax rate than the working class. The Triumph of Injustice by economist Emmanuel Saez and Gabriel Zucman of the University of California at Berkeley presents a first-of-its-kind analysis of Americans' effective tax rates since the 1960s. It finds that in 2018, the average effective tax rate paid by the richest 400 families in the country was 23%, a full percentage point lower than the 24.2% rate paid by the bottom half of American households.
God bless this wonderful country. Look at this, guys. A billionaire now pays less. Oh, this is what this country was founded on. The rich avoid paying taxes, and the normal schlubs, they pay the most.
Yeah, and when the rich get too crazy with their gambling, the normal schlub just bails them out. Gives them $1 trillion to fix their stupid mistake so they can make it all over again.
I can't wait. I can't wait to pay to bail Wall Street out again.
Oh, man, wasn't it
so
great
awesome.
The last time?
I can't wait to go through like 10 years of economic hardship so that we can bail Wall Street out one more time.
Let's look at this. In 1980, by contrast, the 400 richest had an effective tax rate of 47%. In 1960, their tax rate was as high as 56%. The effective tax rate paid by the bottom 50%, by contrast, has changed a little over time. So basically the bottom fucking 50% going pretty much a flat line. And these rich fucks have just gone lower and lower and lower. To now it's like they pay even less than these fucking than poor people.
That's awesome.
It's wonderful.
Gotta protect the billionaires though. Gotta
and
protect
I love,
them.
I also love when giant corporations that made billions and billions of dollars in profit pay nothing. That's my favorite personally.
Well, of course. I mean,
I like when they don't have to pay anything.
TJ, look, they're investing in our society. They're investing.
Right.
They're the job creators, TJ. They're in fucking making all the money.
Amazon.
Creating all the stuff. Yeah, Amazon.
Yeah.
Jeff Bezos needs that $115 billion, TJ. If he doesn't have it, I mean, what, you're going to have it? Come on, man.
Yeah, that's gross.
That's disgusting.
He won the game. He won the capitalist game, so he deserves to have a better quality of existence than everybody else.
Goes the spoils, TJ. Yeah. Render unto Caesar what is Caesar's, TJ.
And he won, and everybody else in America lost.
Yeah.
Unless we decide to change the rules of the fucking game.
Yeah, changing the rules is not fair to these billionaires. I mean, these poor fucking... Look, TJ, is Jeff Bezos not going to fucking be able to fund some space project now because you want to tax him? That's disgusting. You're a fucking disgusting person.
I am an enemy of progress. It's true.
Can I ask you guys a question, though? Seriously.
Yeah, ask me a question.
At this point, do you realize the seriousness of what you're talking about, though? Like, in terms of what it would take, you're not just talking about taking back a system or fixing a couple of little leaks in a system. You're talking about completely and utterly changing the way that business and government is done in this country.
I don't see what choice we have.
But do you understand the upheaval that comes with that?
A massive upheaval.
I mean, this country was fucking founded on massive upheaval.
One of our biggest
industries. And it's gone through several... Since
one of the biggest industries in the U.S. is the medical industry,
I don't think upheaval is anything new for America.
And if you had Medicare for all tomorrow, like you had that, that would be a fucking, I mean, how many jobs? I mean, it'd be fucking millions of jobs lost overnight,
right?
I mean, because if you eliminate, like, there's like 900, was it? I think Bernie Sanders tweeted this out, like $939 billion a year in medical fucking waste. I mean, you're talking about almost $1 trillion right there that's money that's just being wasted on bullshit. And if you take a lot of that out of the system suddenly, that's a lot of fucking people's livelihoods going boom, poof.
Right.
And that's one thing.
That's right. That's one industry.
Right.
That's one type of industry. I mean, I've talked at length about the amount of waste that I saw just in the school district that I worked in, extrapolating that out to the, what, tens of thousands of school districts across this country.
Hundreds of billions of dollars every year.
Hundreds of billions of dollars every year being squandered. So.
It would be...
We're talking about a complete and like, honestly, do you guys think that at this point, the way that we do things can be retooled enough to where it's not this lopsided? Or do you think that we need to change the whole game we're playing?
Yeah.
Because the game was designed in a lot of ways, especially over the last fucking 60, 70 years by the very people that were trying to oust to support them.
No, I mean,
we're talking about a gutting.
I mean, you're basically arguing,
the introduction of like the level of technology that we have now and the impending AI technology and the automation stuff. And I mean, all the stuff that's like, we're going to be forced just by innovation to radically transform society.
Well, who's talking about that?
No one.
Almost no one.
Andrew Yang is talking about it to some extent.
You're talking about, like, the wheel is broken. You know, it's stuck in the fucking mud. Or we just need to break the wheel off and come up with something else. And, I mean, at this point, I mean, if you're looking like 50 to 100 years in the future, it's going to have to radically change. There's no fucking question. I mean, it's going to for sure. But if it's going to get better for the average person instead of getting worse, then this is going to radically have to fucking be reformed and changed. And I mean, like, we've already talked about automation. When all these jobs go bye-bye, what happens?
Am I wrong in thinking that the root of this problem is, like, the capitalistic impulse? It's this idea that money is status. No matter how you slice it, if you've got more of it, you're better off.
Yeah.
Isn't that the fundamental ill that has to be fucking addressed here?
Yeah, I mean, I read something about how
in capitalism, for you to gain, someone else has to lose.
Right.
Right. Well, it's like a game of Monopoly, right? Which I guess there's a study out there that shows that in Monopoly games, typically one player ends up with 80% of the money.
Right.
So, I mean, it does seem like there's going to be inherent inequality built into a system that's driven by the profit motive.
It just seems logical to me.
It is.
So how do we fix that? What does that look like at the end? That's the question that I get asked a lot because I don't advocate for the current system continuing in its current form.
Right.
But I don't know the answer. How do we pick up the pieces of this system that is literally so broken it should be evident to every human being on the planet?
I don't know what the end game is, but I think that the next move in the game for the people, if they want to actually try to get something done, is you're going to have to fucking get the taxes high on these motherfuckers. You're going to have to invest in a social safety net. That's like the bare minimum framework of the work that needs to be done.
Doesn't
going
that just
the future.
Kick the can down the road in a system like this? Look how we've looted Social Security.
Right.
Right?
Yeah.
This great social program that ensured that you didn't have to die alone in a crusty old house, that you had a little bit of income to carry you
well,
into your
twilight
years.
Well, I mean, the problem is that in any sort of system like this, like, there's always a fucking enemy that has a different agenda, you know?
Well,
so we're never going to, as long as there's another team that's fighting against you, you're never going to have a perfect fucking solution. And even if we did have homogeneity of purpose, there would still be...
The other team is stacked inherently. Whoever's
right.
willing to go the furthest for the dollar
mm-hmm.
gets the power.
Yeah.
That's the way it's going to exist no matter what we change. So we could pass Medicaid for all tomorrow or Medicare for all
right.
tomorrow
sure.
and then watch it be looted progressively over the next 40, 50 years to the point where it's a laughable joke and we're right back where we started and then we pass another one.
Yeah.
That seems to be the cycle. When it comes to these kinds of social programs, food stamp programs are passed and then slowly but surely borrowed against and gutted in favor of deregulation until they're just a laughable joke.
Well, yeah, look who writes the laws. If the corporations write the laws, like, they don't give a fuck.
Isn't, in effect, us going like, we got to work within the system and pass some of these laws against some of these billionaires just seeding this long war? Of every 30 years, they come back to loot what we've gained.
Yeah, I don't know how you get out of that, though.
Yeah, I don't know how you break the wheel either.
Well, if we don't have the answer to that, then we're all just fiddling on the deck of the Titanic here doing this voting shit. Because, honestly, dude, it's a game of kick the fucking can. Unless we deal with the fucking... And it seems so obvious to me what the problem is.
Yeah, but here's my thing to you. Okay, let's say you say, okay, there's no fiat currency tomorrow. There's nothing. It's everyone just working for, you know, a common purpose or whatever. Like, how do you motivate those people to do that?
Fuck me, I don't know.
That's the only reason why, you know, it's like, look, of all the systems we have, this system does suck. But the one thing it's really good at is motivating people to do shit. And that's the only reason why it exists, because people, if they know they're going to make money... I don't know why it is. I don't know how that fucking works. Adam Smith called the invisible hand. It's just something that pushes you out there to do shit. And, like, I get what you're saying. It's like, look, if we're going to constantly be in the same space and the rules are written by these people, how does that ever fucking change? And you're right. But I don't know. I mean, do we have to get to a point with technology where just money becomes obsolete? Because, like, you can have everything you want, so there's no want, then...
I mean, look...
But doesn't that lead to overconsumption? I don't know.
All I know is that the first stage of ever having a chance to get out of this is unstacking the deck enough that the people actually have the power to make any sort of transformative change in the first place.
I mean, maybe you're right.
But I think that we've gotten to that point before. I think we're at that point under FDR, but the Republican fucking, you know, conservative sort of mindset... pro-business mindset obviously reasserted fucking dominance. So
I just think,
how do you prevent that from happening again? I don't know.
You don't.
You can't prevent. You can't prevent ideas from coming about.
You can't prevent the guy that's willing to cut the lowest getting the biggest dollar reward from ending where we are now. You know what I mean? You can't prevent that cycle unless you address that fucking impulse. Unless you address the idea that a person should have to trade a profound percentage of their life in drudge work just for enough of this ethereal idea to get by on.
To get ahead.
So that a very few elite can hoard this idea to the exclusion of everybody else. I just don't understand. If you don't address that, you don't address the problem, in my opinion.
Yeah, if you have a giant parasite hanging off of you, it doesn't matter how much, like, give him another blood transfusion.
Right.
If it's still sucking the blood out, you know, what's going to happen? Eventually, it's going to get all of it. No, I understand entirely where you're coming from. It's just like, I don't, if someone had that answer, you know, and this has been recognized, you know, going back to fucking Karl Marx, going to the Communist Manifesto, looking at saying, like, look, there's workers. The worker's busting his ass and he gets nothing at the end of the day, and the factory owner gets richer.
But we're rapidly approaching the point in history
where you don't even
we don't need workers.
Yeah, you don't even need the factory worker anymore.
Not as they're envisioned by Marx, not as these fucking glorious laborers that trade the sweat of their brow. We're talking about, like, the ability to replace that drudgery with automated processes.
Yeah.
So the worker doesn't exist anymore. That sounds like a capitalistic nightmare gone wrong. So now they don't need us at all, other than as consumption.
Yeah, so why do you think the idea of everybody getting automatic money every month has come into the fucking equation?
I mean,
I think it's a recognition of, at some point,
it's like, hey,
we know these jobs are going to be gone.
We're going to fucking just keep you running on the hamster wheel. Here's some baseline money.
Yeah. Here you go.
This is going to be the life support system for our capitalist enterprise, so we can keep a consumer culture going until we figure out how to just cut you out entirely.
And I mean, look, and like, look, if you look at it, there's so many
things. And poison your fucking Cheerios or whatever.
There's so many things in this fucking country, dude. It's like the average amount of a new car loan, more and more cars are unaffordable to most people. Housing is unaffordable to most people. And it's just all these metrics. If you look at our society, it's like, nope, nope, nope.
So I've noticed that we've been leaving some people behind in our outreach efforts.
Yeah.
So TJ, will you do sign language for the message tonight, and I will be doing the message in Espanol.
Okay.
Okay. Por favor, señores y señoras, necesito dinero. Ayúdame. Ayúdame, por favor. How do you say eat? Comida. Comida. Por sale. At the Pessimist Productions Patreon. Go now. Become one. Or don't. And be a loser.
Oh, I'm so hungry.
Be a loser for the rest of your life.
Don't be like us. Be a winner. Join now.
Thank you. Thank you very much.